Because I prefer to say hi. I have been always connecting with you 18 plus. I teach in senior college. I must say that I enjoyed this experience of connecting to students below 18. So you have such immense energies. You are so happy. By looking at your faces itself, I got so much of energy today. So coming back to the competition that was, this was an innovation competition. I'm sure both the earlier judges have given you really valuable inputs. Even I have noted them down. It is important to pay attention to the medium through which you communicate, that is the language, the grammar. It is important, because this is an oral communication, to pay attention to your intonation, your pauses, everything. It is important to also pay attention to your body language. All these inputs were really wonderful. But I would like to talk about something a little bit different, just in order to differ from them. One important thing you must remember, why elocution, why another debate, why oral communication? You must realize that oral communication has been the backbone of democracy all over the world, right? Then elocution as an art form of persuasion, of persuading people, as ma'am said, in effect agree with what you are saying. This has been the way in which politicians, statesmen, legislatures try to appeal to people and convince them about what things they have thought for the purpose of the nation, right? This art is, that's why I say, the backbone of our democracy. So by trying to be as natural, as persuasive in this art, you are, might be tomorrow, going to be the statesman of our country. You are the people who are going to see to it that our democracy lives on. And democracy lives on in the democratic manner. That you are going to talk logically, convince people about your points, and make others agree with you. Or might be, you honor somebody's disagreement and agree with that disagreement. And it is this that is very important in the art of elocution. So while you prepare for yourself, pay attention to what others are speaking. Pay attention to their style, pay attention to their content. See to it that when you talk, you can repeat that content if possible. And that's why you should prepare for elocution naturally. Right? Instead of mugging up the points in your hands, it's better to be alive at the time of this elocution competition, to listen to others' points and think that you can come up with something extra, something more, some value addition. Right? Generally, when you talk, you have some points at the back of your mind. But all these points should flow not in the help of words, but with the links of logic. Because words may fail you. If you forget one word, you are at a loss. And then there is this, as ma'am said, there is this awkward pause. And then that intimidates you further. And then you fall into this loop of not being able to continue. But if you let your logic flow only really naturally, words won't fail you, because logic will take you ahead. So whichever the topic given to you, let that seep in. From the inner recesses of your mind, whatever your teachers have brought wonderful inputs about what these topics try to rather expect it from you. So think about that logic. Let that logic flow naturally. Language and words will follow automatically. If you keep that as the backbone of at the back of your mind when you participate next, I'm sure you will do wonders. I'm sure you will be able to do to your heart's content. Because after all, if there are 8, 9, 10 participants, somebody has to be first, somebody has to be second, somebody has to be last. But that I have spoken to my heart's content, that I have spoken to the best of my abilities, is a satisfaction each of you must carry back home. I must say the junior wing has been amazing, because at that age I might not have the guts to stand in front of it, keep the mic in my hands and talk. And the senior ones have, of course, been really wonderfully suitable to be called senior enough. I'm really happy that I'm taking home a lot of learning points from you as well as both the judges. Thank you so much, Subha ma'am. Thank you, Devi, Ganesh ji, for inviting me here and giving me this wonderful opportunity. Thank you.